Erev Tov, I'm Stephen Ben-Dinun, and you are watching Israeli News Live. We have shocking headlines today. There was a woman that was publicly beheaded at 1 p.m. In London, England. According to the report, it was actually posted by a news agency called Mad World, and says the headline reads, "Woman publicly beheaded broad daylight on London street." Police had been called in to and alerted to a stabbing. By the time they got there, and they also had dispatched a medical helicopter, the woman was found dead, and she had actually been beheaded. Now, the ironic thing that was reported in this article was that when the police were asked, was this an act of terrorism, they tried to downplay it. Well, it is an act of terrorism, without a doubt. It is Muslim terrorism, or Muslim extremist, I should say, that is definitely trying to send fear. And there's so many people that are in the extremist community that desire jihad and believe in Muslim extremism, that want to eradicate the world of all Christians and Jews. And we're going to see more and more of this. And ironically, even in the democracy, the democratic world, and such as Europe and the United States. So we need to brace ourselves, be vigilant about where you go and who is around you, because you never know who could be the one that would be next. It's very sad to hear of this woman that this happened to her, and our condolences can only go to her family, as well as the reporter, Steve. He was actually an American reporter that was recently killed. We knew that Steve had been for quite some time, had been captive by the radical Islamic groups over in Syria, but he was also beheaded after his mother had made a very passionate plea for the release for his life. But he's also Jewish, and Steve had made a recent aliyah a few years back to Israel. And so unfortunately, especially with him being both American and Jewish, it seemed that his hopes were very slim indeed. It seemed like the old way that the Islamic extremists used to do, and that was to kidnap their people in order to use them for ransom to free more Islamic terrorists from the prisons and things of this nature, but that seems to be going by the wayside. And of course, we're also hearing reports that Palestinian leader of the PLO, Mahmoud Abbas, is requesting another 9 months of negotiations. Only this time, he said, before they can start the negotiations, there must be a predetermined outcome. And that would be that there would definitely be a Palestinian state, and that Israel would return to the pre-1967 borders. Well, it's kind of ironic. That's a little bit about what Barack Obama, the president of the United States, wanted to do, was have a predetermined outcome. Interesting. Another 9 month negotiation. So it's hard to say what will happen. I know Israel is not accepting the idea at all. And of course, the top news of today is reported at ABC News when Shimon Peres spent 45 minutes at the Vatican and suggested that the Vatican kick off a new UN, but not United Nations as far as the military concerns, but a UN of religions. He asked the Pope if he would consider doing something like that, because all the strife in the world, as he put it, is a religious strife, a religious war. The murders and killings are all done in the names of different religions. So he suggested a UN of religions. Well, it sounds like to me, if you think about it, that's right up the Pope's alley. What he wants is a one world religious system anyway, the Chrislam, and now he's got the Jewish leader Shimon Peres, president or former president of Israel, pushing for this type of idea. I commented on the article here in ABC News, and I said, what next? Does not anybody begin to wake up and recognize that the Pope of Rome is indeed the prince that would be of the people that would destroy the temple and the sanctuary? If he's not the actual prince himself, then who is? He certainly fits the criteria. I'm Stephen Ben-Danoon with Israeli News Live. Erev Tov.